Inspiring you to set the marketplace ablaze in partnership with an awesome and limitless God. This is the Kingdom Driven Entrepreneur Podcast, and this isn't business as usual. Here's your host and chief fire igniter, Shay Bynes.
Welcome back to the Kingdom Driven Entrepreneur Podcast. This is your host, Shay Bynes, and our goal here is to inspire you to operate your business completely yielded and in partnership with our awesome and limitless God. My guest today is Tammy Wheeler. She's a part of our Igniters mentoring family, and she serves as an executive coach to high-level corporate leaders. We have a great chat about what it's looked like for her to embrace the leading of the Holy Spirit in her business. What I enjoyed so much about what Tammy shares is that she has found so much joy in seeing how God shows up in those small and consistent ways as she has leaned into his voice and direction. Everything that we talk about on this podcast is all about continuing to increase our appetites for more and more of God's presence in our businesses and just creating a lifestyle of a partnership with him. Now, before we get started, I do want to let you know some great news because we only open up Igniters a few times per year. And next week, the doors will be open for Kingdom Driven Entrepreneurs flagship offering, which is our Igniters mentoring community. If you want to experience the power of mentoring, you know, authentic community, accountability, and just that overall support for growing and thriving and doing business by the power of God's grace, you will absolutely love your Igniters experience. So head on over to kingdomdrivenentrepreneur.com/igniters and go ahead and read up on all the details and hop on our email notification list so that you don't miss out when the doors are open for just a very short time next week. Now let's get started with today's conversation with Tammy Wheeler. Listen in and enjoy. Tammy Wheeler, how are you, my dear?
I am well, thanks. How are you, Shay?
I'm doing great. It's lovely to have you on the podcast. You and I have had a chat before, but no one got a chance to hear it.
Yes, correct.
So we're doing this another time, and now everyone will get a chance to hear it. So I'm looking forward to our chat today. Tammy, you're part of our Igniters mentoring family. And I really want to have been being very intentional about having those who've been a part of Igniters to talk about their own adventures of doing business in partnership with God and what it looks like for them and the type of work that they do. And so why don't we get started? You're an executive coach. Not everyone even knows what that looks like and what that means. So why don't you share with us a little bit about what you do and then tell us how you got started and the work that you do?
Okay, sure. Well, thank you for having me. I love this podcast and I've referred many people to it because I love it. So what executive / leadership coaching is I work with typically director and above and sometimes more frontline managers, but usually more senior leaders in mostly corporate environments. And these are usually large global corporate organizations and sometimes are smaller. I have one CEO that I've done a lot of work with in his business. That's smaller. And it's working typically one-on-one with these directors and VPs and up and helping them to really, it's hard to explain coaching because I'm a certified coach, ICF certified coach. And what we do is to go in and pull out what's great in them. So there isn't, you know, a can bring in materials, training. A lot of times that comes out and we help them with that, but it's helping them really do mind shifts, create goals, hold them accountable and support them. And then I can tell you because I actually do surveys from their stakeholders, amazing things happen all the time.
I love that. And now how did you get started in this work?
My whole career, I consider myself a bit of what I call a corporate refugee. I left the corporate world. gosh, it's been a good, I can't believe it, 15 years, time flies. But my whole career was in human resources and then organizational development. And I worked with the internal side of helping with the people side of the business. And that's really, I love business. I always have. And I've always been pretty entrepreneurial. But what I love, absolutely love, Shay, is the people side of the business. And so many times leaders get thrown over a fence and told good luck with that, especially I worked at Intel and high-tech, technical types of leaders often need some help with the people part of it, and they get thrown over and promoted, and then it's like, help. So that's what I do. I help them with the people leadership of their business and how they influence and work with other people in the business.
I don't know if you've ever done business where you were like, this is business, this is my spiritual life, and they're not really quite combined, or if you started in business with this revelation that God desires to be involved in this business. Talk to me about kind of where you were when you started.
And it's probably a bit of both. I think you did a good job of kind of melding it. So I became a Christian when I was 18, literally the day after I graduated from high school. Grew up in South Dakota, moved out to Oregon. So I've been out in the Portland, Oregon metro area for a long time, because that was many years ago. And kind of had tough stuff. I lost my parents in high school, pretty tough, and had to really grow up fast, to be honest. I was pretty much on my own by age 18. Because my siblings were so much older. So throughout my career, and literally at age 18, I was dealing with selling our home, selling our stuff. I moved in with the family in high school. And so I had to be really, frankly, tough. And I figured that out. Like, either I can lay on the floor in a fetal position or get going and move on. And because of that, just like I see, I use a lot of assessments. A lot of times those strengths become actually weaknesses when they're overused, right? We see that. And so like I use a Hogan assessment with a lot of my clients and myself. I'm high and bold. I'm high and very direct. All these things that helped because I had to have that. But on the other hand, as a Christian growing, it has been learning to submit. It's learning to partner. It's learning to let go, not trying to control everything. So a lot of those things have helped me. And now as I'm growing in my walk, frankly, in my business, is learning to trust God more, let go of the planning. A lot of what I loved your book, I read it a year and a half ago on Grace Over Grind. Perfect for me because I can grind. I'm a type A all the way. I've always worked in very driven corporate environments that expect a lot. And I worked a lot of hours all my career. And so bringing that into business and learning to submit and learning to listen and learning to be more driven with, you know, listening to the Holy Spirit has been really exciting, sometimes hard, and then actually amazing. Like, I look back in the last year and a half and I think, wow, I am truly learning to be at peace. And this has been a wackadoodle year for all of us. And I literally have not been worried about it. And my friend I partnered with recently on some work for a women's retreat. And I'm like, you know, it's going to be fine. Let's just not worry about it. And it's literally happening. So I just want to encourage everyone that's solopreneurs, smaller businesses like mine. It's hard and it has impacted my business with COVID, but it's working. And God's been totally, totally providing. He has always provided for me. Always, since I was 18, he's always taken care of me. And even more, I see it in my business.
Understanding that you were on your own at 18 for the most part, that says a lot by itself. Even if you weren't in the corporate kind of driven thing, just the fact that you had to grow up super, super fast and essentially operate out of reliance on self, you know, quite a bit, or, you know, I got to handle it. I could see how that could translate over into the working world in terms of, you know, how you show up. So yeah. Since you've been experiencing a bit of this adventure, which you expressed as sometimes hard, also amazing, also full of peace, give me just some, even if they're just small examples, but give me like practical examples of a difference between how it used to be for you and then some of the differences that you can see, the evidence of your shift. Talk to me a little bit about what that looks like for you.
Okay, this one's going to sound really weird. In fact, how I found you. I was working with a coach at the time, and she's a good friend, and right now I'm not currently with her, but she referred me to you and your website. And she's actually different, a little bit different faith, different way of looking at things. But she said, you might want to talk with these guys. And so that started this whole adventure with you guys and really listening to the podcast of Kingdom Driven Entrepreneur. And as I've been doing that, big change. What she and I came up with was Vishay. This is going to sound so weird. I just deleted this week about five or six different things I'm subscribed to because I get all these, especially now with COVID and stuff, and we're all locked down much more. You know, try my blueprint, try my marketing, try that. And it just gets overwhelming. And early on, my spiritual gift, one of them is discernment. And I just kept saying, nah, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't buy it. And I don't, but I was afraid to let go of those emails because I had FOMO, like, well, what if I miss some fabulous marketing thing that will change my life? And I finally let go this week. I just realized that, Shay. And what I realized is I hate to market. And most coaches do. We don't like it. We love to work with the people and see results and help them. And what I learned with this coach, she finally said, why do you keep struggling with it? And I said, because you have to. It's part of running a business. Duh. And she's like, why don't you stop doing what you hate? And it was so powerful. I'm like, okay. So I really quit marketing. And what's going to sound bizarre, it was the best year I ever had. And so you're laughing because I made really good money. And in fact, it was so good, it carried into the first half of this year. So when a lot of my business slowed down, I had longer term contracts that kept me going clear until June from last year. So what happened in a nutshell, Jay, is the more I started praying and letting go, the more my business thrived. So that makes no sense from a purely logical view, worldly view, but from a spiritual view, it does. And that's been so fun. And I'm enjoying it so much more because I don't like to market. And now my market is more, it's all referrals. It's following up with people. How are you? It's more service, checking in instead of, you know, I have to go out and do something on social media. That is not me and I don't like to. And so I've changed it and I've actually enjoyed my work so much more. And I'm not freaking out, even during this last crazy year.
Yeah, that's a lot just right there. One, the peace in the midst of, you know, kind of world chaos right now. Oh. So being able to maintain peace in this elongated season that we've been working through, walking through is huge for someone if you're used to, you know, kind of being wanting to be in control of certain things or wanting to know how things are going to work out. So the piece, that's huge. But I love what you shared around this thing with the marketing. It's like, I mean, word of mouth is its own marketing. But basically what you're saying is this preconceived notion of what it means to show up, to market, and to do all the things, the checklist of 10 things that I need to do in order to, you know, deliver a message and show the value that my services have to offer, all of those things. I don't have to rely on that blueprint and that strategy for this thing. I'm really believing God that he can move in the midst of my preferred, desired, and strongest way of showing up in this topic called marketing our business. And that's a part of letting go because it's contrary to what the message would be, you know, the blueprint, the expert marketing or whatever with all the steps and all the things. And you're saying, forget those things. I'm going to trust God and I'm going to do this a different way. And I'm going to trust God to increase the work of my hands. And you saw him do it.
Yes. And can I give you this week? I have a cool example. Thank you, God, because I can share the story. I just finished with a client that I had worked with for a year and a large high-tech firm that I work with often. And I work with brilliant people. I really do. And I was so sad. She's like, I'm going to miss you. I said, me too. And I looked at, I have notebooks for all my clients to keep myself organized. And I was down to like, it's one. It's looking really thin. And I was sad. I said, I'm going to miss you. And then that very week, a client, I compete typically with three or four other coaches from the same organization just hired me. We're just waiting for the final paperwork. And then another one came out of the blue from a client I do assessments for, that for their hiring process. And so in one day, I got two executive coaching projects that are pretty big and pretty good paying out of the blue without doing anything. And so what I'm saying is it happened, Shay. And I was looking, thinking, wow, Lord, it's getting a little thin on my desktop. And you know what? Two in one day. And so that's an example. a real life stuff that is happening. And it makes me, I'm having fun. It makes me happier.
I'm curious to know about what it's like with kind of the engagement with your clients. You know, you're a people person, you love working with people, you're coaching and all of those things. And I'm curious to know what it's looked like for you to really lean into the voice of the Holy Spirit and trust that the Holy Spirit speaking to you. Like, what does that look like for you, even in your client engagement? Have you grown in that area? And have you been surprised by something God's done in that way?
Yeah. So this is a message I'm hearing to tell you guys. I sometimes, with my own clients, a lot of my clients are working on their leadership presence, their confidence. They're brilliant, smart people and successful, but they sometimes struggle with imposter syndrome, especially the women. And I've had a women's group I did this started this year and looking at how we communicate. So women's rise and shine group. And so I struggle with it too. And I'm an executive leadership coach that has some of that imposter syndrome. Like, whoa, I'm not strong enough. Like this guy that just hired me is very senior level in a big global company. I'm like, God, I don't know if I can do it. And then I literally said, wait, I prayed and said, if I'm not the right coach, shut that door. If I am, please open it. So I had to go back and say yes or no. And that was, it's hard because this guy is intimidating. He's a VP in a big company. And so that's how it works for me. Shay is very practical. And then what I wanted to share is sometimes when I hear, first of all, we should not ever, ever compare ourselves. It never is helpful. I don't think that comes from the Holy Spirit at all. And I do it. And some of your people on the podcast, the guests, have such amazing stories. I remember one where the guest said, we got a whole building. He was in real estate at the time for a dollar, you know, that was worth multi-millions. I'm like, what? That didn't happen to me. I haven't had that. But what I'm finding is it's those smaller things for me. And it's the day-to-day as an entrepreneur, and especially as a solopreneur. And what happens, like I've had things where we have to get back in 24 hours if we're interested in being considered for the coaching opportunity with the company I subcontract, and I've missed the email. And I hear a voice saying, go check your email. I'm like, what? I already checked my email. And then I go and see this saying, let us know, you know, in the next 2 hours if you want to be considered. And so it's these smaller things, Shay, that I'm having fun seeing it happen. Or I'll hear like a voice say, call your client or pray for your client. I'm like, okay. And then I do. And then the connection happens. So for me, it's more these smaller things, consistently seeing it, that is big versus a giant thing that has just fallen in my lap. So that's how the Holy Spirit's been showing me, teaching me. And literally what I do every time I coach, every time, is I pray for wisdom and discernment, because coaching, and it's a great coaching, is not in the kind of coaching I do, is not telling people what to do. And sometimes you'll bring in tools. I have lots of stuff in my toolkit, but I don't walk in with an agenda like today you're going to work on this. It's entirely on what they want to work on. And so the Holy Spirit, sometimes I'll bring up something and I'll literally be thinking, I have no idea what to ask or say. And I'm just like, help, help, God, help in the moment. And then I'll ask a question and they'll say, oh, that question is amazing. Let me think about that. So where did that come from, Jay? Because literally I have nothing. I got nothing for you. But God is giving me that in the moment on a regular basis. So that's why I love coaching, because amazing things happen, and isn't that me? And I'm working mostly in the secular world. That's where I've always been called. And so I'm not openly able to say I'm a born-again Christian, here's what I'm doing. But sometimes it comes out in little things, or I'll say I'm praying for you. And blessings have happened to some of my clients that are just, it's spiritual. I absolutely believe that. And they don't even know it. It's behind the scenes.
That's really good. And that's rich. I love the way you were talking about how it's in the small, consistent seeing God move. Because that's what really this is all about anyway. We're talking about a lifestyle of doing business in partnership with God. And so, yeah, so along the way, sometimes you'll have something rather spectacular that happens. There's like the small miracles and the big miracles. There's just being able to see God move. Quite honestly, just the simple example that you gave about what could have been a missed opportunity that God didn't want you to miss. Right. You know, I don't want you to miss this opportunity. Check your email. I have something for you here, you know? So that's really good. And so, and also when I think about your client set, you know, you're talking about, you know, some of them may be believers, some of them are not. You may not know immediately, you know, sometimes they may share it, they may not or whatever, but it doesn't matter. The fact of the matter is that you have God. You're operating with him. And so he's giving you wisdom. He gives you discernment. He gives you even good questions to ask that you may not have thought to ask, that might not have been in your toolkit, the things you normally ask, but yet he shows up in that way. And so I think that's really powerful, because I think some people might be nervous thinking that, you know, well, because I don't know if they're believers or not, you know, I'm not sure how to navigate. Should I actually share the thing? Should I ask that question? That's not in my toolkit. Should I actually risk it? And should I actually ask this question? And so tell me the truth. Did you have a hard time? Do you have a hard time, or did you ever have a hard time going away from I'm putting the script in quotes, but going away from what you know is like your proven ways of doing things and doing something a little bit different, because you really feel like that's how the Holy Spirit's leading?
So you're going to laugh, because I thought about your story, you know, how much you do. And I'm so inspired by you. And I literally thought this once, like, well, she's not like me, because I'm a planner and I'm a type A and I'm super driven. And then you shared, Shay, that you were, and I work with mostly technical analytical leaders, a lot of them. And then you shared that you're an engineer by background. And I was roaring like, oh, I get her. She's my peeps. I'm not an engineer, but I'm married to an IT guy. I love technical people. And so that encouraged me to go, oh, you can be a recovering planner, type A grinder. And that's what I would consider it, is that. So I guess, do I ever get totally blown away? Here's the thing that's going to sound weird. I am actually what you call a cautious risk taker. You know, I left my corporate job. I had a very good six-figure paying job and benefits and stock and all that to start my own business. That right there was huge. And it took me a while. I literally hit burnout in the corporate world, like physical, emotional. I was shot. And I just held on so tight. Like, I can't do this. I can't walk away from this really good paying job with golden handcuffs. And I did. I finally did. And it took a long time. So right there, the beginning of my own business was huge. That was a huge risk, doing everything against what I thought was logically making sense. I had stock, I had good pay, and everything in me screamed, get out. You know, it was God telling me, but I was holding on so hard, white knuckling it. So that was how it all started. And then on a regular basis, it's more that. I think it's just, I watched friends go up the next level. The next level for me would have been a vice president of human resources. And everything in me said, don't do it. You're going to be miserable. And most of them were. And most of them, one lasted like a year and a half in this big job. She hated it. So I think from the very beginning, it was that. And I think for me, I'm a cautious risk taker. So, and it literally shows that on my Hogan profile, that I'll take risk and I like it, but I'm careful. And so what I have to learn, I think I'm inspired by people like you to be a little bit more. And I think God's been nudging me to play bigger. And I'm just holding on like, oh, I don't know if I want to play bigger with bigger audiences, bigger groups, but I'm starting to venture into that. So I think it's more play bigger than I am. But just from the very beginning, for me to even just walk away with no job was huge. And so through the years, there have been things. And then this year in particular, I've ventured out doing more virtual and online. And one of them, I had already marketed it and got it going starting in March before COVID had really hit. And I'm like, thank you, God, because it was my first virtual thing. And of course, we're going to be doing more and more, and I am in my business. But that was God telling me, do it. When I kept saying, I'm called to work with people in person. I teach classes at a university. Love the energy of an audience in a group. Well, guess what? That's kind of gone. It's all virtual. And so I think he was telling me early before I got it that, hey, you got to start doing stuff virtual. Get off of the big platform thing. And you know what? I'm like, thanks, God, because at the time, it really didn't make sense. I was planning all this in January before it all hit the fan.
Wow. It's so funny you said that, because I've heard a testimony similar to that several times, where someone said that in the beginning of this year, they were already sensing like this need for a particular type of pivot. They weren't pivoting in the midst of COVID. They were pre-pivoting. They were pivoting pre-pandemic, not knowing why they were doing it, not knowing exactly how to do it in the beginning, but just making those shifts. And it was just like, it was preparation for what was to come. So as opposed to trying to scramble, it was like there was already things set in motion. It's like, oh, okay, well, we're just going to flow in this direction and see what God has for us over here. And so thank God for that.
Yes. And again, is that huge rock the world? No, but it's another example of partnering with God. And if you listen, he has it together, right? He's your boss. And that's what I'm learning, is you can trust. And what's been weird for me, I went through the Igniters mentoring, and at that time it was the one-on-one, which I led with Alicia. I loved working with her. And she said something, I've never really seen prophetic things like this. And she said, I see you doing a lot more speaking. And it really rocked me, because I keep hearing that, but it's not coming together. And it's been like 3 years of this day. And I'm like, okay. And this was in January of this year. I'm like, oh, I'm so excited. And she said, maybe big groups. And then of course, COVID. So it's not happening, but there's something there. And I'm just trusting, even though 3 years of hearing this and kind of starting to venture a little bit, doing some training and things on speaking, I think something's there and I'm just going to let it go. And I'm not worried about it, Shay, where in the beginning I was like, what is it? I can't figure it out. Now I'm just letting it go. And I'm starting to do more work. We just did some work on the brilliance of resilience with some Christian women. And we had a group of 15 last Sunday or Saturday. It was a virtual retreat, my friend and I, a colleague. And it was wonderful. It was a real blessing. And it was scary. This is going to sound funny, to step into working with believers. And it was for women of faith. And that's who attended. And it was just fun. And there was we had a whole thing on God's promises that we gave to them, and how what I do brain-based coaching, and it goes with the whole verse of whatever is good, whatever is lovely, focus on these things, how psychology and neuroscience goes with the Bible, you know, and it's just been exciting. And what I'm seeing, it's fun to go pull out these powerful verses versus trying to find good quotes, you know, in a presentation. I'm like, wow, this stuff's way better than anything I could say. And so I'm getting excited about working with more women and believers. And that, I think God's telling me, do more on this whole topic of resilience. And I shared some of my story about losing my parents and how that's played in some of what I shared in the beginning that was in my head. And just hearing their stories, it was just powerful. So I'm loving that and starting to venture into the scary world of working with Christians, which sounds hilarious, but my whole career, it's always been secular world. So we'll see where it goes.
That is hilarious.
I know it sounds really silly, but it's out of my comfort zone.
Yeah. I mean, it's something that's different, you know, it's something that's different. It's a expansion from where you are to including something else. And that's good. And I want to go back to something you said around, you know, just God's word, that you just keep hearing this thing around speaking. And one of the beautiful things is just like, when we get these words from God, it's like we have to steward those things. But what you said that I thought was powerful is like, you have surrendered the timing of it, which I think is really key, because it's like, just because God said it doesn't mean it's tomorrow, right? It's just like, but there's breadcrumbs and there's things that we experience that we go along the way and we begin to see, how things start to come together. And before we know it, we look back, whether it's 3 years later, 5 years later, 10 years later, and we're like, wow, I see God in the midst of that, that entire time. What he said is true. If he said it, he meant it. That's it. It settles it. And it's just a matter of stewarding that. And I think part of doing it by his grace is that surrender to his divine timing for when certain things that he has shown us, seeing those things take place in the fullness of what he's shown us. And so I'm excited for you. I'm excited that with this inclusion that you have of the word. And I thought it was hilarious. We were talking about, picking out quote, it's more fun looking in the word and seeing, oh, wow, look what the Apostle Paul said, that was good. Look at what James said. That's fantastic. Right. I mean, I love that. And I think this is good. I think this is really good. I love what you've shared about your journey over this last year and a half. I know that there's so much more goodness to come. And so I appreciate you sharing your story. How do people get connected with you? Where do they go?
Okay. And we're going to do more on this brilliance of resilience. So for women, especially, it's my email, if they're interested, is, or if they need someone to talk on that topic or anything like that, it's my name. So it's Tammi, T-A-M-M-I, and it's like common sense, but people sense, PeopleSense.com. And my website, if they want to know a little bit more about me, is www.peoplesenseLLC.com. And then I'm also, I do a lot more, I'm going to do more, hopefully, on LinkedIn. So if anyone wants to, it's just my name, Tammi Wheeler, Wheeler, and I'm on LinkedIn. So.
Thanks for joining me today, and thanks for sharing with us.
Thank you. I love what you guys do, and I just want to encourage people listening. My life verse is Isaiah. It's up here on my wall. It's Isaiah 40:31. About they that wait upon the Lord. So it is that waiting sometimes. And sometimes it's smaller things before they're huge. So, just keep consistent with it. Like you said, it's a work in progress for me and I love it. So thank you for what you do and for all the rich resources and things you share with all of us. I love it.
Thanks for joining us on the Kingdom Driven Entrepreneur Podcast. If you've enjoyed what you've heard today, we encourage you to subscribe and spread the word. And don't forget, you can gain access to even more resources, plus a thriving community of fire starters by visiting our website at kingdomdrivenentrepreneur.com.